A battery is a device consisting of one or more electrochemical cells with external connections provided to power electrical devices. Batteries come in many shapes and sizes, from miniature cells used in wristwatches to small thin cells used in smartphones to large lead acid batteries or lithium ion batteries in vehicles. There are two types of batteries, primary batteries and secondary batteries. Primary batteries are designed to be used until exhausted on energy, then discarded. Their chemical reactions are generally not reversible, so they cannot be recharged. When the supply of reactants in the battery is exhausted, the battery stops producing current and is useless. Secondary batteries can be recharged, that is, they can have their chemical reactions reversed by applying electric current to the cell. This regenerates the original chemical reactants so they can be used, recharged and used again multiple times. A battery's capacity is the amount of electric charge it can deliver at the rated voltage. The more electrode material contained in the cell, the greater its capacity. A small cell has less capacity than a larger cell with the same chemistry, although they develop the same open circuit voltage. Find out more about characteristics of batteries like capacity, chemical content, voltage rating, etc. Let's see how water analogy can help us better understand about voltage, resistance and current. For better visibility, ink color is added to water. We can think of this water bottle as a battery, a place where we store a certain amount of energy and then release it. If we drain our bottle a certain amount, the pressure created at the end of the outlet goes down. We can think of this as decreasing voltage, like when a flashlight gets dimmer as the batteries run out. There is also a decrease in amount of water which flow through the outlet. Less pressure means less water is flowing, which brings us to current. In this analogy, amount of water represents charge, pressure represents voltage, and water flow represents current. Plastic body of pen is attached to the bottle. Open end has more area of cross section while nozzle has less area. Flow through nozzle should offer more resistance to water flow. It takes more time to drain the bottle. Larger outlet offers less resistance, hence water drains faster. Time to drain the marked area of the bottle is measured for different outlets. It took 25 seconds to drain the marked area of smaller nozzle, while it takes 20 seconds with larger area. When two outlets are provided, it took 16 seconds to drain marked area. Though resistance of system increased, more path was provided for the water to flow. Hence, effective resistance to flow of water is decreased. As we increase the length of outlet, it also offers some resistance to water flow. It took 540 seconds to drain marked area when length of pen was 4 meter. Same pipe with 1 meter length took 180 seconds to drain the marked area. Two bottles with water at different level results in pressure difference. If you connect these bottles with pipe, water flows from higher pressure to lower pressure. When two levels become equal, there is no flow of water as pressure difference is zero. We can say that there is no current flow when potential difference is zero. Try this activity with different bottle sizes and different pen bodies. A circuit diagram is a graphical representation of an electrical circuit. Components used to build circuits are represented as symbols instead of pictures. LED bulb is represented like this, while power source such as battery is represented with two vertical lines of different sizes. Conventional current flows from positive terminal to negative terminal. Wires are lines that connect circuit elements in the circuit diagram. In actual life, the wires might be pieces of copper that are connecting the different elements. But in a circuit, they are going to be basically lines. Wires also have zero resistance and zero voltage drop. We know that that's not true in life. Everything has some internal resistance. But for now, we can assume that they have zero resistance and zero voltage drop. One AA battery is not enough to light the LED, so let's add one more battery. Adding the battery also changes related symbol in the circuit. We also added resistor in the circuit to limit the flow of current. Not adding the resistor might blow the LED out. That's the symbol of a resistor, a bunch of zigzag lines. It doesn't matter how many zigzags are there, It resists the flow of electrons in the circuit. Switch is used to toggle the current on and off in the circuit. Though we have used wire itself to act as switch, there are separate components which perform the same function. Switch in open position is shown like this, while in closed position it is shown like this. Current is flowing when switch is closed. This junction indicates that wires are connected. For crossing wires that are insulated from one another, a small semicircle symbol is commonly used to show one wire jumping over the other wire. A voltmeter is an instrument used for measuring electrical potential difference between two points in an electrical circuit. A voltmeter in a circuit diagram is represented by the letter V in a circle. It is connected in parallel between the two points of measuring potential difference. Ammeter is an instrument which measures the current flowing through any two points of an electrical circuit. Ammeter in a circuit diagram is represented by the letter A in a circle and is connected in series in the circuit. When variable resistance is required in the circuit, rheostat is used and is indicated with this symbol. Using the slider provided, we can decrease or increase the resistance of the device. They are used to divide the voltage or control the current through a circuit. Rheostats are often used as power control devices. For example, to control the speed of an electrical motor, to control light intensity, make them brighter or dimmer, to control the temperature in electric oven and furnaces. Though wire used in rheostat is normally copper nickel alloy, simple rheostat can be built by 34 gauge enameled copper wire to understand the concept. Round plastic jar is wound with wire. Coating is removed from one straight line. Washer is inserted in bare copper wire. Sliding the washer changes the effective length of the copper wire and hence changes the resistance. You can see the same when this is connected in series to simple circuit. Intensity of LED changes as we slide the washer. Try drawing circuit diagrams with these symbols for series and parallel connections.